Let's roll. Oh, I need Priyanka. Are you still here? I need you to give us permission to record the screen. Priyanka, tell me you're here and snooping around. Priyanka.
I like this friend.
So I. Well,
he's like, is she lighting a giant joint?
And Avalok is our supervising. He's supervising the shoot.
We think this music you're making is not very good, and we can't tell. No, they couldn't tell me if it was good or not.
I don't know who I am, but you're the Shero Kirani. We're at ScoopWhoop Cafe with Raja Kumari. Wait, I'm just one second.
I see you in the front there. I see you right there.
All right, let's go. Okay. Hi guys, welcome to another episode of ScoopWhoop Cafe, a space where a lot of performers from different genres and different spaces come together to perform, speak to us, chill with us, and basically have a good time. So today we're going to have Raja Kumari.
I'm so happy to be here. What's up?
So good to have you. All the way from?
Los Angeles, California.
Oh God, crazy. So before we get down to everything, the music, the hip hop, how is quarantine treating you?
You know, I've settled right in. I kind of already lived this life. I'm either fully on tour 24/7, like go, or quarantined. Like I don't go outside. If I'm not on tour, I'm just like in my house and I'm just like ordering Swiggy and I'm just like with my dog. So only difference is I'm in America because of the COVID chaos. I came back to the US because my family's here in the US. So I didn't want to be in India without, you know, direct family there.
So these are the struggles that you've had recently, but like in your life generally, like, and what is explained also in NRI, right? Like talk about the duality. How was it like growing up in the US as an Indian? Like how can you shed some light on that experience?
Yeah, you know, it was, I always tell my friends in India that they're really lucky the way they grew up in a lot of ways, because when you looked at billboards or you opened magazines, it was people that looked like you, that looked like your mom, that looked like your uncles, or it was like the girl at your school that you liked. You know, I looked in magazines and there was not one person that had my skin tone, my hair, my kind of nose, my eyes. They weren't wearing clothes like me. They didn't have jewelry like me. And for me, I was, you know, I'm Indian classical dancer. So that's like as traditional as it comes. So I'm sitting in 3 hours of makeup as a 6-year-old wearing like 30 pieces of jewelry, flowers, full costume. And that was, you know, my life. So I didn't feel like I ever wanted to give up that side of me, you know, but I always felt that I didn't belong in a lot of ways. And I always felt at home in my dance. I always knew that like I was part of this like ancient, unbroken culture that was greater than everything. That would, you know, I was always very ethnocentric, so I felt like, oh, India's best, you know, East or West India's best, like it's better than America in a lot of ways, because I felt like, I don't know, I felt like America's only been here for 250 plus years, you know, that's it. So it's like the culture is a melting pot, it's based off of everybody else's. So yeah. It's like there's this desire to assimilate, but in India it's unbroken.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
it's just like from the Mahabharata to today, you know, it's like gangster. But I think I just found like a lot of strength in that, and that made me not want to leave behind who I was.
Fair. Okay, what are you going to be playing for us now?
Let's do NRI. Let's go for it. Yeah. Da 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 da. I love it when they big man, talking shit on Instagram. They don't know I'm woke, I guess they really think I'm ignorant. That's why y'all still middlemen, while I bust up and make the bands. Trying to put the wall between us, Pakistan. Culture vulture, die here eat samosa. Too brown for the label, too privileged for the cosign. Kohino stolen, crown jewel of the ocean. But no country for women, I don't fit in neither quotient. Trying to rip my people, but they say I'm not their leader. And I'll ride up in the bleachers, feed up what y'all eating. Sorry that my story ain't Indian enough. And America don't love me cause I'm Indian as fuck. Do you even know who you are? Tell me, what are you made of? What you afraid of, hater? Cause I let you tear me apart. Show you what I'm made of. Is this what you're afraid of, hater? Yeah, seen them on the comments, I ain't brown enough to comment. Guess I got to get the tan so I can rep a country. Give my daddy options, I don't rep y'all for the concept. Don't live here for the content. Trying to village off the struggle, took me out of context. Indie on your third eye, but the third eye closed. Got you on my back while you slit my throat. When I land here, they tell me go home. Now you ain't gotta love me, but it's still my. Trying to rep my people, but they say I'm not their leader. And I'll ride up in the bleachers, feed off a Charlie M. Sorry that my story ain't Indian enough. And America don't love me cause I'm Indian as fuck. Do you even know who you are? Tell me, what are you made of? What you afraid of, hater? Cause I let you tear me apart. Show you what I am made of. Is this what you're afraid of, hater? Huh. India, your third eye, but the third eye closed. Huh. Then look at him. Huh. Then look at him. Yeah, yeah. Got you on my back while you slit my throat. Like you ain't gotta love me, but it's still my throne.
Crazy. 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 That's insane. I can't imagine how much you want to vibe with people to this, man.
I know how crazy that Indian is, fuck, in India. I can't even imagine doing that. I can't even imagine doing that in Bombay right now.
There's a lot of people who want to follow their dreams, want to follow their passions. It's a bit of a cliche question, but what would you...
I think maybe other people have it worse because my parents are at least were really supportive of art in general in the house. I think it can be really difficult for people that parent whose parents think like music is a waste.
Yeah.
My parents were like, we think this music you're making is not very good and we can't tell you. Like, they couldn't tell me if it was good or not, you know? If it was Celine Dion, they could say, well, this is melodious and I liked it. You know, but they're always like, why do you have to say things like that? And, you know, they've been cool. I have to sit them down before every release and tell them every lyric, what it means. And I have to like tell them, you know, okay, I'm sorry, Dad, but I did say, you know, the F word here, but it's for artistic, you know, it's for artistic credibility. Like it has a lot of merit and weight here. I didn't just say it like in a vulgar way, okay? He's like, okay, you know, because like they have to be cool with it because they're gonna post it on their Facebook, you know. And they're very happy when they meet my fans, you know, when they meet young girls and people and even young boys or whoever, and they tell my parents that, you know, the music inspired them, then they're happy.
As a catch, we've got 2 minutes remaining on this meeting. I'll have to call you back with a new Zoom call.
I'll stop recording this one.
Yeah, so that we can take a break on the clips. Recording.
I like this frame. Okay.
Long time no see. How's it going? Sorry, this is fat. What is this?
He got his weed. He got so scared.
I was like, this is
like, is she lighting a giant joint?
Yeah, the Pineapple Express inspired.
I just wanted to vibe.
Okay, crazy. I just like to thank the producers and all for getting me to host Raja Kumari here so that I can feel like this feels amazing. Thank you guys. I just love, okay, what I love about your music more than anything else is the way you fuse, right? Like the way you fuse the classical and the hip hop, right? It's crazy. Like if, for me, the where it's done really crazy is Meera. I like the way Meera plays out.
You know, Meera was like, for me, it was like an act of like revolution, because like at that time I was making my album and, you know, I'm making it in America and there's a lot of opinions about how this is supposed to sound. I mean, like, I'm having like fallouts with like huge multi-platinum producers because they believed that my project should sound a different way and I'm like, no, it's supposed to sound like this. And I wanted to write a song about what it feels like when you're dancing, because I tried to explain to people that like it's like Manasa Puja when you're doing classical dance. Like you do puja for God, you put everything, the garlands and everything, but there's nothing in your hand, but there is, you know, there really is something in your hand. So that offering is supposed to be more valuable than like actually putting like flowers or gold or whatever. Because again, I never felt seen, you know, and like Indian classical dancers are not celebrated in Bollywood. They're not celebrated anywhere. Like where do you see a classical dancer? You don't. And that's unfortunate and sad. So I always had this goal to put classical dancers in my music videos, and you're seeing more and more classical girls appearing in pop culture, and I'm proud of that. You know, that's what we wanted. So the lyrics, both feet drumming on the earth, can you feel the vibration? It's about dancing and like being one with God. And that's why this is the first time I did the fusion with the jati, the thal, and the song. So it was really for my dedication to dance. But yeah, should I do Meera now?
Yeah, please.
The No one sees the real. They think they know what you need, but they lie, wishing that you're all alone and forgotten, locked up in a cage. People change, but jealousies never die. Things they rearrange, bridges burn. That's just life. In your darkest days, see the light. From the bottom, then you elevate. Padagum guru bandh mera na chire, padagum guru bandh mera na chire, padagum guru bandh mera na chire, padagum guru. Both feet turning on the earth, can you feel the vibration? Rhythm heard around the world. Your frequency in sync with the universe. Can you feel the vibration? Raja Kumari, daughter of the king. How long you think that you could keep up with my tempo? Dance to the rhythm, dance in the Himalay. Ain't hippin' what they say. Dinner, heart beatin' like the bass. Dalangu tak dekhu tak thadi gina thom dhaki ta tak je. Dalangu tak dekhu tak thadi gina thom dance to with the dance in the Himalay. Ain't hearing what they say. Dinna heart beating like a bass. Both feet drumming on the earth, can you feel the vibration? Rhythm heard around the world. Your frequency in sync with the universe, can you feel the vibration? Sound wave coming off the earth and your third eye is awakened. Rhythm heard around the world. Your frequency in sync with the universe, can you feel the vibration? Every single person has a chakra system inside their body. And if you open yourself to the universe and you ground yourself to earth, you can charge yourself. And through that energy, you can manifest anything. Anything is possible. And usually if I was on a stage show, I'd say, this is pure manifestation. And that's how I'd hit the end of that, but.
Crazy, dude. That's crazy. I can't believe I have to sit down. I want to get up and begin.
I love that it's just like you. It's like my audience, but just like one. Like really give you this performance, you know?
I'm feeling blessed.
I see you losing it. I love it. I see you in the front there. I see you right there.
So, like, what's your take on diss tracks and, you know, like rappers going against each other, calling each other out and fans joining in and stuff like that, you know, like.
But you have to understand that diss tracks are a part of, like, the history of hip hop. Like,
yes.
I feel like it's so interesting because I grew up in America, so I grew up learning the history of hip hop. Like, currently, like, I'm like, okay, these are the forefathers of hip hop. These are the ones that influenced this. And I watched hip hop grow from, like, Nas and Tupac when I was, like, a kid to, like, you know, watching Future and you know, DaBaby and whatever's going on now. You see this evolution, but it had its phases, you know? Rap battles where they're literally battling. They're not like battling like, here's my verse versus your verse, who's better? Yeah. It's like, no, it's a your mama. Like that happened, you know? Yeah. That was part of culture. And I think in India, this is the first time that we've ever seen anything like that. And that's why I think there's been such a phenomenon with, you know, with the guys and with the boys and their diss songs. But I think it's just part of it. I think that's how it is. I think they're just doing it with words and they're not beating each other up in the streets.
That's true. Like Tupac, no Tupac Biggie over here, hopefully.
Yeah, nobody's shooting each other. I mean, at the end of the day, like Emiway and Divine squashed their beef in like 3 days.
Yeah,
And the streets of Mumbai are safe again, you know? So it's okay.
Raja Kumar, we've got now of course, which interview is finished without a cliche rapid fire round?
Let's go.
Yeah. Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah. Always. I stay ready.
All right. What are you listening to right now?
Telugu music.
Winning a Grammy or topping the billboards for 10 weeks straight?
Grammy.
Favorite Indian sweet?
Jalebi.
What is your pet peeve?
What's my pet peeve? People who don't text back and leave the red receipts. Ugh.
Fair. Gross. 90s hip hop or contemporary?
90s.
Favorite Indian film?
Just like that? Bahubali.
Okay, crazy. I would have guessed that. Mainstream or underground?
Like what I listen to? Because I'm mainstream, but I mean, I love the underground.
Fair.
Yeah, because I listen to underground music, but I don't particularly need to like beef with everybody. I just want to make pop music and talk a lot of shit, actually. I talk a lot of shit, but not to anybody specifically. It's just like to the world, you know? Yeah.
Favorite Indian rapper of all time?
Favorite Indian rapper of all time? You guys already have the answers written. You just want to hear me say this. No, favorite Indian rapper of all time? A.R. Rahman, Patti Rap. Don't at me.
Tupac or Biggie?
You can't choose. I'm going from California. I'm going to say Pac, even though I love Biggie, but Pac.
Favorite track of all time? Or like your one go-to track? Or like that one track which you're like...
Oh, like for all time? Like I just can't ever live with them. Ready or Not, the Fugees, like Lauryn Hill.
Okay.
Ready or Not, here I come. You can't hide. Mm-hmm. I'm going to find you. And take it slowly. I play my enemies like a game of chess. Come on.
All right, fantastic. All right. You killed that round, I must say.
Yeah,
you killed.
You tried, I saw how you tried to trap me, but it's okay. Gully gay, Gundi gay, huh? Kumari, Gundi, Run and tell your mommy. The streets go over, bum, 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 bum. It's coming from the gully. It's coming from the city slums, slums, city slums, slums, city slums, slums. Yeah, Raja Kumari, I go harder than anybody. Daughter of the king, American dream. Fit me this way, Hindustani. So don't misunderstand me. I do it for the people, yes, I do it for my family. Mainly, I'm gonna get it, I'm with it, I make it.
Run, run.
I'm gonna get it, I'm in it, until it's
done, done.
They tried to stop me, don't make the same mistake. They tried to copy, but they can't take my place. Cause oh God, all eyes on the underdog. Go hard,
go hard.
No time for your none at all, whole squad. Four times on the boulevard, running through the streets of dogs, flowing like the Ganga. Run and tell your mommy. The streets go ra pa pam pam, ra pa pam pam, ra pa pam pam. It's coming from the, it's coming from the gully. It's coming from the city slums, slums, yeah, 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 yeah. Chucky boo, chucky boo, chuck the boy in it. A gully gang in the sound of the slums. For my little Bombay, know we coming up. You know we coming up. You know we coming up. A jackie pooch, up the body man. A gully gang is the sound of the slums. From LA to Bombay, know we coming up. You know we coming up. Run and tell your mommy. The streets go ba 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 ba. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's coming from the gully. It's coming from the gully. It's coming from the city slums.
Ah, fucking kick ass, dude. Kick ass. Okay, I don't know if I should do that. Actually, I wrote a small, I'm really bad, okay, at rap and like at hip hop and music and all.
It's okay. I judged MTV Hustle. You go ahead. Go ahead and rap for me. Let's go.
Please just don't blacklist me from.
I won't.
Okay. All right. I'm going to try my best. I don't know, set up and all. I can't believe I'm doing this. Okay.
Don't worry. Relax. Everything's okay.
All right. ScoopWhoop Cafe with Raja Kumari. I don't know who I am, but you're the Sheru Ki Rani. I hope you're liking this. Oji Kahani, because I'm talking of no one else but Raja Kumari. Gonna try with the song, it could be right or wrong. Being from two spaces made her really strong. There are millions today jiving to her songs. From the land of the Americas to the land of the bongs. Your tunes are lit and your beats are crazy. Hoping someday you collab with Nazy cause. Cause I don't know who I am, but you're the Shero Kirani. We're at ScoopWhoop Cafe with Raja Kumari.
Kumari, okay. I see you. I like the confidence. I see that you mixed the Hindi and the English. You're in the Hindi. You went for a Hinglish rap.
Yeah.
I like that. So, I support this.
It's fine.
I think you gotta like kind of get into the zone a little bit, get into that pocket. You know, you gotta catch that pocket and that tone. Yeah. You're gonna get it. I like where you're starting.
Thank you. But enjoy the rest. Enjoy the success of NRI. And it's
Thank
been
you
such
so
a
much.
Pleasure to chat with you. It's been such a good time.
Been such a good time. You stay safe. You stay inside.
Will do. Can you help me out with the CTA? Let's go. 1, 2, 3. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share, comment, and
make sure you subscribe to ScoopWhoop and check out my new record, NRI, available everywhere.
Awesome. Thank you so much. It's been such a great time.
Okay, you have 3 minutes and 13 seconds. I gotta go. Bye.
All right. See you.